in a game of hot potato where the loser will be left with a 10-digit price tag, Sweden punched back after the Canadian Taxpayers Federation endorsed their bid for the upcoming Olympics. The CEO of the Swedish Taxpayers Association endorsed Calgary in response to Calgary endorsing them. I was at the Canadian side of this taxpayer standoff. Check it out.
If the Olympics was able to come to town without using taxpayer dollars, the CTF would support it. Sadly, this is just not the case. Calgary doesn't need to waste billions of tax dollars to be a great city. So let's grab a Swedish meatball and let's cheer for our friends in Stockholm.
It is an unprecedented time in Olympic history. For the first time in well over a century, there very well might not be a single city even bothering to make a bid for the Olympics. Currently on the roster of potential cities, we have Calgary, Stockholm, and a joint Italian bid. Each and every one of those cities is looking more and more like they will withdraw from the process entirely. In Italy, the leaders of the host cities are playing musical chairs with each other, and in Sweden, the bid is on the brink of collapse after a government shuffle. And Calgary, well, we're set to vote on the issue on November 13th. I was at a town hall hosted by City Councillor Jeremy Farkas, and this is what the folks there were saying.
I think we don't have enough information yet, and there's nothing to guarantee these games won't cost more than the $5.2 billion that's projected right now.
I don't think it's worth it, not at this time, not in Calgary.
I did not find a single Calgarian there who supported the bid, other than the elite few getting paid to do so. Keep in mind, the CEO of Bidco is getting paid 68% more than the Prime Minister of Canada's base salary. Now look, I'm not against the idea of international sport. I don't think anyone on the no side is. I think that people are just in disbelief that Mayor Nenshi, who makes $200,000 per year, can be so out of touch with the fact that almost 50% of Canadians would be in financial ruin if their paycheck was delayed even a week. According to a watchdog group, the Calgary Olympics could cost at least $2,000 per household in Calgary. Bidco seems obsessed with this idea of legacy. Well, we are too, and what is unacceptable is leaving a disastrous financial legacy for future generations. The going rate for these games are in the billions of dollars, and cost overruns are just par for the course. The Olympics will disproportionately hurt the poor. With that in mind, how dare Nenshi and his band of lefties support this? On November 13th, every fixed income senior, every student saddled with thousands of dollars of debt, every single father, I predict that they will be scrambling to vote no to Nenshi's vanity project. Their livelihoods depend on it. For the Rebel Media, this is Keean Bexte. On November 10th, just 3 days before the plebiscite, I will be speaking along with Maxime Bernier, Ezra Levant, Sheila Gunn-Reid, and so many others at the Rebel Live. You can get tickets to that at therebellive.com, but they are going fast, so get them while you can. And don't forget, of course, to vote no to Nenshi's vanity project on November 13th.